Hello and welcome to Web Technology Core Concepts at Learning Journal. In these videos, we are trying to build a sound foundation for learning and understanding things related to web technologies. Hyperlinks are one of the most important constituents of a website. We already talked about hyperlink or simply a link in an earlier video. However, in this video, we will try to explore and understand it in a little more detail. The term hyperlink is not new. This term was first used by Ted Nelson as a mechanism to link related information. Later, Sir Tim Berners-Lee used it in his development of HTTP protocol. Since then, hyperlinks are being used to link related content over the World Wide Web. At the most basic level, a hyperlink is a pointer to a resource. These links may point to a variety of things. Some of the commonly used resources are listed here. HTML documents, specific parts of HTML documents, images, videos, file downloads. This list is not exhaustive. In fact, you can create a link to anything that lives on the internet. I hope you already understand that anything or everything that lives on the web has a URL. The URL is used to identify and locate the resource. So, to create a hyperlink that points to a resource, the first thing you should know is the resource URL. Once you have the URL, rest is simple. We will learn more about HTML in a separate video series. However, HTML offers a simple mechanism to create a hyperlink. Here is an example HTML code. If you save this code in a test.html file and open the file in a browser, you will see something like this. In this example, the text Google is a hyperlink. However, behind that text, we have an HTML tag. This tag is known as anchor tag that is responsible for creating hyperlinks. If you look at the code carefully, we have a href attribute. The attribute href stands for hypertext reference. The value of href attribute is a URL where we want to point the link, right? That's what I said earlier. To create a hyperlink that points to a resource, you need to know its URL. There are a variety of things you can do with the anchor tag and customize your hyperlinks and their behavior. We will talk about those things in our HTML tutorials. However, the objective of this video was to give you a realistic sense of the hyperlink. I guess I fulfilled the purpose. That's it for this session. See you again with a new concept. Thank you for watching Learning Journal. Keep learning and keep growing.